Hey everyone, my name is Justin and welcome to another episode of Tell Me About. Today's episode is about, wait. I want to tell you guys a little story first and let's see if you can guess what today's show is about. All right? I sat in the grass and looked up at the sky and suddenly I saw a dragon float by. It turned into a mouse, and that turned to a tree, and it turned into a unicorn looking at me. I saw a house and a lamb and a man with a beard, and right before my eyes, they all disappeared. Oh, wait, here comes a dinosaur, and there's a little cat. Can anyone guess what I'm looking at? So all those things changed shape as they floated by in the sky. So can anyone guess what today's episode is about? If you said clouds, you're right. We can look up at the clouds and see shapes and imagine all sorts of things as they float by our heads. But that's not all clouds can tell us. Well, clouds can't actually talk. But if you know something about clouds, you'll be able to know what they're communicating. We're going to discover some of that today. And we're going to learn some fancy new words as well. So get ready. Now, imagine for a second. What do you think it would be like to live inside of a cloud? Do you think it'd be like floating on cotton candy? Or maybe it'd be like bouncing on a giant fluffy pillow? Or maybe it'd be soft, like walking on cotton balls? Well, I'm sorry to say, but it wouldn't be like any of those things. Clouds may look soft and bouncy and fluffy from where we are down here, but if you get up really close to a cloud, you could see that it's made entirely out of water. Yeah, warm air rises from the earth, and this warm air holds teeny tiny droplets of water. So when millions of these droplets of water all group together really close, they form a cloud. Sometimes, clouds form really close to the earth, down on the ground. As a matter of fact, you might have walked right in the middle of a cloud before. Have you ever been outside when it's misty or foggy out? You know, the air is wet, it's damp, it's kind of hard to see in front of your face. Well, guess what? That fog is the same thing as a cloud. It's just really closer to the ground. So, you know, it's not soft or fluffy, it's wet. So the next time someone says to you, oh, the air, it's so misty and foggy out, yeah. Well, you could just tell them, oh, that's just a cloud coming to visit. And one thing we know about clouds, they're always changing. So let's take a look at some of the different types of clouds. Big, white, fluffy, puffy clouds that look like cotton are called cumulus clouds. When the wind blows, it moves the clouds along the sky and changes their shape, often making them look like dragons or tigers or unicorns. So what do cumulus clouds tell us? Well, they're usually saying something like, oh, it's a beautiful day. You can go outside and play, ride your bike, have a picnic, just enjoy the day. Oh. But when these cumulus clouds get filled up with more and more water droplets, they get bigger and darker, and they don't look like cumulus clouds anymore. These clouds are called nimbus clouds. So what do nimbus clouds tell us? Rain is on the way, they warn. Or maybe even a snowstorm. These clouds are holding a lot of water and they're about ready to burst. You probably don't want to be caught outside when nimbus clouds fill the sky. Nimbus clouds bring heavy rain and thunder and lightning. But isn't it cool that we can just see these clouds and get a warning about what the weather's gonna be before we get soaking wet? What about those blah days where gray clouds fill the sky, like one big gray blanket? Those are stratus clouds. Stratus clouds often come during the winter. They let us know that if it's cold, we can expect some light snow, or maybe a little light rain. Ooh, here's a fun word for you. So do you know when it's raining, but it's not really raining too hard, but it's still kind of lightly raining, like you're gonna get wet when you go outside? That is called drizzle. Isn't that a fun word? Drizzle, drizzle, drizzly drizzle. Ooh. Okay. No. Goodbye, gray skies and drizzle and bye, stratus clouds. Oh, look, they floated away. And now, let's say that the sky is filled with these clouds that kind of look like wisps. These are called cirrus clouds. They're way, way high up in the sky. As a matter of fact, they're so high up that the water droplets inside these clouds freeze. So cirrus clouds are actually made up of ice crystals. Some people, because of the way the cirrus clouds look, call them horsetails because they kind of look similar. Yeah, I can see that. So not only are cirrus clouds the ones that are the highest up out of all the clouds, they're also the fastest because of all the super fast winds that are moving them along. So what do cirrus clouds mean? Well, they usually mean that the weather's pretty good. No rain, no snow, but they also usually mean that the weather's about to change. So be prepared. What time is it?
It's joke time!
I can't hear you. That's right, it's joke time. All right, kids, here's today's cloudy joke. What did one raindrop say to the other raindrop? Two's company, three's a cloud. Okay, I got another one. What do you use to wrap a gift for a cloud? A rainbow. Get it? Rain, bow. Okay. What did the cloud wear under its clothes? Thunderwear. All right, anyways, back to clouds. Airplane pilots usually look at the clouds in the sky to see if it's a good day for them to fly or not. They love flying when they see big, puffy cumulus clouds. They don't want to fly into any dark gray nimbus clouds, no. Pilots try their best to avoid flying in nasty weather, storms, or big scary clouds. But there are special airplanes and special teams whose job it is to fly right in the middle of those kinds of clouds. Right here, you're seeing a whole bunch of clouds forming together into one super, super strong storm down on the earth. Storms like this are called hurricanes. And you heard me right. Scientists have airplanes and teams of people whose job it is to fly right smack in the middle of these hurricane clouds. Now, what do they think they're doing? Are they crazy? They're actually very brave and very specially trained. They fly into the middle of the storm, also called the eye of the storm. There, they can gather tons of information about the hurricane, which can be used to save lives and property. I'm hearing thunder. You know what that means, right? It means I should have paid attention to those nimbus clouds before coming here. They would have told me that a thunderstorm was on its way. All right, I'm gonna get going before I get drenched. And next time you go outside, why don't you take a look up at the sky and see what clouds are there? See if you can tell the difference between a cumulus, a nimbus, a stratus, or a cirrus cloud. You might even find some unicorns and dragons while you're looking. It'll be fun to be able to look at the clouds and see what they're telling you about the weather. And in the meantime, remember to always be clever. Oh, geez, this is my nice shirt. Oh.